Hi, this is Paul from Foresight Tech. In this video, I will show you how to find the standard deviation for a data set with the frequency using Excel. Here is the question. We do have frequencies for the data value, and Excel does not provide us a function to directly find the standard deviation. So we have to use a formula. Okay, so here's the formula. Standard deviation equals, okay, so this is the symbol. What does it mean? Well, k, so here, is the number of individual data value. How many? In our example, 5, because we have 5 different data value, 1, 2, 4, 5, 8, right? So k is 5. X1, X2, go to xk at the individual data value. In our example, we have x1 is 1, x2, x3, x4, x5. And the f are the frequencies. Okay, so frequencies here. And the n, what is n? Here is n. N is the sample size. It's just the sum of the frequency, right? X bar in the formula. X bar is what? Is the mean of the data set, the average. Okay, so which is this formula. Use the data value times the frequency that the products add together, okay, and then divide it by the sample size. And then let's use the Excel to find the standard deviation using the formula. So first, let me type the data. So X value, I'll put this column, okay. Let me put X here. So what is X? 1, 2, 4, 5. And 8, right? Let's put the frequency on this column. So I put F here. F is 2, 3, 4, okay, which is 2, 3, 4, 3, and 1. Make sure our data are correct. 1, 2, 4, 5, 8, 2, 3, 4, 3, 1. Yes. Okay, so now the first step, we need to find the n sample size. Let me put the n here. So n equals, n is the sum of the frequency, add all these together. You can use order sum or use the formula sum. Okay, parentheses. Highlight the data, the frequencies, parentheses, enter. So which means that the data, the sample size is 13. The second step, we need to find the X bar, okay, which is the mean. So let me put the words here. So the mean should be equals, where the mean? Here. We have to use a function in Excel, which will be easy for us. This means a product is the sum of the products of the frequency and the data value, which means what? Which means use the frequency multiplied by the data value, that the product, add all the product together. So this formula is called the sum product. Okay, and then you can use the frequency is the first input, X is the second input, parentheses, or you can switch the order. So X times F is the same. This is the numerator, and then divide it by N. Where is N? Click here. N is 13. That's the formula for us to find the mean, and then int. What do we get? We get the mean is 3.615, like this number. The second step, we need to find, x minus x bar square, because each term we have this value. So let me put it in this column, okay? So here is a parenthesis. X minus mean, right, raised to the power of 2. I just put the words to remind myself, okay? So here we do need to use a kind of operation. Okay, see, follow. This is the procedure. Highlight this box. I need to put all these value here. And then I put equal sign. Use the parenthesis first. Use the x. X is here, right? So I highlight all these x. And then minus x bar. So x bar is here. Click. And then parenthesis. And then raise to the second power of 2. Okay, so now it's not int. We have to touch 3 keys at the same time. Control, Shift, and Int. Keep in mind, touch, click 3 keys at the same time. Control, Shift, and Int. See, that's all these values. Now, I can use the formula. So, I put here standard deviation, which is this formula, square root. If the name of the square root is SQRT, square root parenthesis. And then the top, you know, is just a product, right? It's some product, again, of what? Of the frequency, which is this column, comma. And then is this column, right? So you see, highlight. And then parenthesis. I get the numerator and then divide it by m minus 1, which is 12. If you like, you can use the formula. Parenthesis, click, minus 1, parenthesis, and then end. I missed the parenthesis, so don't forget the parenthesis. And then and so here, this number is the standard deviation. Thank you.